Exactly. Good afternoon, Hazard Heroines, and welcome to Practice Programming in C, where we're going to continue to work on Cinema's mobile version. Let's not go to there, let's go to here. Let's get the music on. Remember, it's just mostly speech-free mode also, so probably won't talk an awful lot. One thing I want to do first is to fix up the get rule mode, get rule function. Just a very simple change, get rule. Basically, going through the style sheets in reverse order. I should also go through the indices in reverse order. Sorry, the rules in reverse order. So that should actually pick the final person, like pick the rule that's probably got the highest precedence, basically. Just to see also, yeah. So when I launch Firefox, the CPU usage goes way up. So what's loading? That's loading. I closed a bunch of these things. Could have something possibly to do with it. Leave that open just for now. Pinch zoom gestures, I'll bleed those. Well, if we want to, we can get them back. Take a look at that information. This tends to be something that I keep referring to. I don't think that's actually the bug that we're talking about. Alright, so we've got fewer tabs now. And all we did there was to do the rule, wasn't it? Change the rule. And apparently it's still able to find it. I think, is that right? The rule is to do with the width, isn't it? Sorry. Yeah, that seems fine. Alright, so that was that. Now, the next thing we were doing was the positioning of the menu bar, of the menu container. And this right here, actually. So, basically, you're trying to find the offset height. I'm console logging it. So if we look in menu offset heights, as we go down, sorry, console lock. This is zero. The reason it's zero is the offset height returns zero when the thing is not visible. So I try to do this. Try to set block and then none. Which gives you the menu offset height of 86. You can figure out what the height should be, but for some reason that then throws off something about it. What I'm going to just try here is, instead of setting the display to block, I'm going to actually say class list add current. Just for the purposes of this, it might not be the right thing to apply to, so we'll have to see. Although I think it probably would be the correct thing. So, okay, we still get zero, that's interesting. That's saying current. So these are showing up. Check about what we're actually talking about here. Visible. Okay, references container visible, I think, is what we're talking about actually. It's not current. So there we go. There, that's how we can get our thing out. So that kind of works. What I'm going to do though, I'm going to do this slightly differently. We don't really want to be computing the height. Perhaps we want to functionalize this at some point. What once we want to run it? I'm sort of thinking. Do like that more. So we know that the max width is going to be that, but it'll just expand to be whatever width it needs to be, I think. Is that right? Well, hang on. The max width would be that. That's the width that. That's been expanded to some width, so I suppose, yeah, we're sort of still using the same width, but this ain't gonna be that, this ain't been expanded. I suppose we don't care, do not care. Offset parents. Such as the nearest ancestor. So I think I could just use that, can't I? Offset top. Let's just see if that does the same thing. That's all you need. It's kind of nice. Yeah, I think that is sustainable. Because all we're trying to do here, I suppose, technically. I was going to say technically the toggler might be not within the title bar, or the or to put it another way, the title bar might not be. Ah, the title bar I'm not going to put positions. But could that happen in the future? Well, it's working, isn't it, for now? I'm a bit wary of here, by the way, is when we're doing this visible, I don't want it to be visible, actually. you're supposed to plot plus half the menu height, and then minus. Sorry, you're supposed to move it down by half the toggle height, actually. And then move it back up by half the menu height. Okay, so what were we doing? We were using a toggle offset. So what is that exactly? True. Oh, I see. So you want to take the toggler off, so I see. Plus half the toggler height, take away the menu height. So now, what that's done is it's centered these guys around the actual toggler. But we're not finished just yet. What we need to do is to make sure that we don't actually protrude beyond the top or the bottom of the thing, basically. I think that can happen. How can I kind of do this kind of easily? I can illustrate this easily. So yeah, that's case in point, isn't it? So we can't have that happening. Basically what we need to be doing here is maxing out the height to the height of the player page. Now it's possible actually that this is within the player page, Within the height of the high bush. So let's just try that actually. Not the player page, the player container rather. Or in fact, it's probably actually the video container. Isn't it? Player container. The player container is this whole thing. Query selector. So you can see when you query selector for the video container, you just get in that. So that's what I'm actually wanting. Well, we've got it. So the video container is already there. So we know. Let's just control log that. So that's 4, 3, 6, and the menu container, the menu height rather, for the specifically for the quotes menu. Menu quotes, okay, so the menu quotes. Will be the toggler, is it? So it's the toggler's class list. Menu link credits filter reference. That's the quotes. They've got the menu height here. You're saying 420. The video container. So height is 436. Yeah, so we do fit in. The area. But we're actually protruding from the bottom. So yeah, we need to sort of somehow say, although we're going to be centering around that thing, not a bad background colour actually. So let's say Although I do like this colour. Kind of. Quite dark. Quite bright, rather. Let's get black. So here's our main container. We've got a got like a toggle that the center point is there. And it's got a box that is like something like this. This bit better. Let me just expand from center. So I'm saying here, we've got a box that protrudes like that. And it's definitely got the space to fit. Just shuffle that across here. Nice. I suppose it could have been nice to do it in a different colour, but well, yeah, let's do it in a different colour. Can I just fill the whole goddamn selection? Foreground, fill all selection. Perfect. Okay, so we've got a thing that's like that. And this is like also the center point of this, it's like there. We know that there's some distance from the top of there to the top of there. I suppose it will also just stick in the menu bar just so we actually know what we're talking about. So we've determined that we know that these guys are aligned, so we know that we can offset from the top to get our position here. And then we know that we can get this point here. About half of that. And then we know how to get the upward movement from the half height of this. Now, we've got the height of the thing. Got the height of the video container. So I think all we need to say is we're just moving it back up by however far this is protruding. Right, that'll be sufficient. And similarly, we don't want to do the same way on the top. Max height. So how do we determine this exactly? We know what the height is. We know what the height of this is. Well, I suppose it's like, if we assume that they're aligned at the top, then the protrusion is going to be the height of this, take away the height of this, which is going to be a minus value, which puts it up there. So yeah, I think I know what this is. It's the height of this, take away the height of this, add the actual menu offset, isn't it? Oh, we've got the dim one, so we don't need to be taking the offset height. So that means that it's not protruding. That's not protruding. This ain't protruding. This is protruding. This is protruding. Okay. And it's like if there is a protrusion, if it's protrusion, protruding. Then we need to decorate the menu offset. Almost still protruding into the thing a little bit. I think that's to do with our padding, isn't it? Yeah, we need to also think about that, don't we? No, that's not right, is it? What do I think? Or is it? Maybe it is, and this just doesn't do that. Oh, hang on. This does seem to be within the area almost. The border width isn't quite in. Maybe this is fine. Do need to sort out the borders situation though a little bit. So I suppose let's just do that. So if we're on left, I think the border left is just going to be none, I think. So whatever size we want. Let's just do it in JavaScript. So the menu style for the top is portrait mode. We want to say that the border top is nothing. Get right mode. Interesting. So it hasn't actually got the collar. Interesting. So the style and width. I suppose you can also you can just set the width, can't you? Actually. Does it? Cool. Cool, cool, cool. And those. let's now just, let's do this. So we're sizing, we're going to do the upper protrusion. This is going to be for like the credits menu, so you should see. You know, as we go thinner, we should be able to trigger a case where this would probably protrude. So we're talking about 479. Let's just add some more people to 479. So there, we still think we should be within the bounds. So to figure out the upper protrusion, what you do is you say, can't be the same computation, can it? No. Don't think. I'm not sure I can draw this in a bit. No. Easy fashion. So let's just fucking draw it. important to say is that it's the same level. So in order to position this, we've done the same procedure. Once we've got the menu offset is the thing that we're trying to adjust. I think if the menu offset is just great, if it's less than zero, isn't it? I think that's all it is. That means the protruding. Protruding. Oh, no, we're not. Yeah, okay, so you can see that that would have protruded. Yeah, I mean, you can sort of see, can't you? The max width this, we could set the max width to be higher, couldn't we? Couldn't we? Oh, hang on, unless we have set the max width, and what's actually happening is that the width is coming along and stomping on it. Oh, hang on, actually. I can just say the menu offset. Oh, the menu height's right there. Yeah, so they have it 440 and 442, so the menu height can't be. Bigger than the video container dim Y. Right, and that's what we're seeing there, isn't it? Also the border left, I suppose. Border left width. That'd be right. Well, I guess we can do this actually. Well, hang on. We can set this after we've set the borders, can't we? Oh no, we can't because we're moving them. Fucking hell. I'll tell you what we want, I think. The menu bars. floor to bottom. So we're not just talking about the menu itself here, what we're talking about here is the actual title bar. So if we're in portrait, title bar should have a top border but no left or right. Oh, actually should have a, sorry, should have a top, oh god, I'm gonna have to do all of them, aren't I? No, I think the ones that I'm talking about on the right, the bottom, and the left. Only one of them has the style, and in this case, it's the one pip, it's this guy. Landscape left version, the right version, the right guy. Gets the thing. Landscape right. The left guy gets it. I'm supposed to say the toggler. The toggler is right style. Oh god. Maybe we don't bother with the borders at all. Possibly. Let's just see if we need the post. Correct me if I'm wrong, but it seems like the menu has got a border. Oh, hang on. Is it just there's a gap. Yeah, maybe let's just do it like that. Because we're on the devices where there's less. There are fewer pixels to play with. Reasonably go with this. Yes, we are encroaching into the indices bar just a little bit. But I feel like we can get away with it. It's a little bit risky, but I also feel I can get away with out positioning this with ways. I mean, obviously, this is an issue, and this is an issue. The width of them. What are we looking at? It doesn't matter how much of this we show, I don't think. God. The player. Oh no, that's nothing to do with the menus. Not necessarily. Let's make a note of it. I mean, size the menu container, that's what we're doing actually, to be fairly honest with you. So these are all perfectly acceptable. So what's different in those that's not in the portrait one? Yeah, I'm not seeing it. I'm going to make a note. Finish with the, we've got that. But what we need is also landscape mode is fine. So those guys are there. Now, did you see what actually happened there? Let's refresh. Toggle over this. You can see that that menu is like plonked up at the top. It's So it seems like you want to lay it out while this is all obscured. Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, these are all fine. Let me just go over to the right version. And just fix up the position of the menu, because I don't think the position will be correct. Yeah, they're not at all correct. Ah, and also the sizing incorrect. So maybe in doing what I'm going to do, I'm going to just copy the landscape left version. Yeah, no, I also need to factor in the width of the people. No, it's not the video container that works. It's just the when you're with. Isn't that fascinating? So just calling, is that right? Just calling that function getWidth. Just calling the function doesn't do it. I can't even remember what I just did there. Link is 351, it's saying. The current is 317, it reckons. Let's just try calling this function again. After we've resized the player. alright. I think I'm reasonably satisfied with this, alright. Just a little bit about the left version. To me, like everyone's actually staying where they should be. Let's look at the portrait. To 5:30, basically the end of the day. So we haven't sized in sympathy, but I think we have at least set us up for success with all of this stuff. So there's one thing I could do actually before I call it a day. In the pretty. This is shared. Menu height is shared. No protrusion. So so it's sort of like compute menu offset, isn't it? Or compute vertical offset. Isn't it? Yeah, I think that's what it is. Compute vertical offset. Oh, I know what that's all about. That is for the half height of the toddler, isn't Like, if you don't factor that in. Oh, they're still protruding into the thing. It's interesting, I would have thought that that would have made a difference. But I guess the lower protrusion. New height. Take away the video container dim. Why? Plus result. Let's just. Oh, I've lost GIMP. Trying to say is if the bottom point is lower than the bottom point of the when the video container dim Y. So that's obviously the video container Y is exactly the thing, isn't it? And it's if the menu height is greater than the video container dim Y, isn't it? Well, no. Results. Plus the menu height is greater than the video container dim. Why? Isn't that it? I think that might be it actually. I think those two tests should differ. So what I'm saying is the menu height. The result is menu height. To get the lower point of the thing. And the video container in Y. isn't that much larger. Video container, didn't worry. Well, hang on, is that just one computer anyway? The menu height. Take away the video container, then why? I mean, you can just say the result plus the menu height, take away the video container, then why? Right, it would be the same thing. Yeah, and then I suppose after having modified this, actually, let's just see if this is interesting at all. Does it still think it's protruding? Which begs the question, am I looking at the correct size? I mean, you clearly see the space above it up here where it could move to if you wanted to. It's the credits menu. The video container Y is 486, apparently. It's 486 all this time. Maybe we don't necessarily need to be too fussed about it. see the menu height, which is at position. The result is where you're going to be offsetting to. Yeah, do you think that's the right computation? Oh, hold on. Did you see what happened there? So, after it sized the player, it actually shrunk the thing a little bit. So maybe that's the source of the thing. Like if I just go like this. Oh, actually not. Focusing on the thing. So if I... No, it's protruding. Bloody hell. What can I click on here? I can get rid of that for a start. So that seems okay to me. So there is a tiny adjustment. So yeah, I think what's going on here is that after we've actually sized it, there's a readjustment of this area here. So I think that's the source of this overlap down here. So we're adjusting correctly. But after we've adjusted this whole thing gets moved around, which automatically sort of resizes this. Going on there. So, alright, I think, I suppose what we've done today, again, it's just, we've really looked at this. I think I better actually just quickly before we disappear, I suppose I should just look at it on the mobile phone, shouldn't I, really? It's on there that it needs to be working. So yeah, sizing and positioning the menu again is what we're doing. Well, yeah, that's not right. Brilliant. I feel they were going to be working on that tomorrow. I think what's going on here, possibly, is that the credits menu has maybe pushed it down a bit. Well, no. Okay. Well, could that be right? I don't know. I mean, it's completely it's screwed it up. Certainly screwed it up. Yeah, it's definitely screwed up. Somebody. Somebody somewhere is forcing the index bar to be at the wrong height. There's no insights to be gleaned from here, I don't think. Just looking through the debug console. I don't think this is going to be right, by the way. Interesting with the title, but I don't know why. It's differing. Nine five 5 9 1. Then obviously 47 because it's just a shorter thing. So it's 5 9 1. And now it's 6:14. So there's something not right about this. And I think this is probably just what I'm going to be dealing with tomorrow, actually. Yeah. Let's leave it there. Tomorrow we'll deal with this. So basically what we've done today is we've sized the sized and positioned the menu's containers. And they're sized and positioned as well as I think we're going to manage it. We haven't done any of the sizing in sympathy. That is going to be the next task. So the next time we come back, we're doing the sizing in sympathy. Let me see if I can just... I mean, we've kind of solved it. I'll say it's done, because otherwise we're going to be here until the end of time, really. So yeah, size indices work correctly. Widthways expand contract vertically for longer, shorter time starts. I mean, sure. And make the video contain grocery is in the size area. Yeah, this is the next task. We're going to be dealing with sizing and thinking for that. So thank you very much, Aidan Harrowwood, for being here, for being beautiful, for being fantastic, and for being well sized, well proportioned. Until next time, farewell for now.